One of the rules of this trip is don't run out of water or you die, so we kind of need water right now.
The night.
Morning, Jarl. Well, these sunglasses, I haven't taken them off since yesterday. I slept with them and they worked. They kept all the sand out of my eyes. It's day five. We're halfway through our trip and we're camped right here on cliff, and it turns out that was a pretty bad idea to camp up here because we got a pretty bad sandstorm last night that just was relentless and didn't stop blowing and just rattling the tent. Blowing dirt everywhere. I think Jarl got out and tried to put his fly on and couldn't. So, yeah, it's kind of a rough night, and it's cold now, but the wind is supposed to die down. It's going to be a beautiful day five, and we're going to go into some uncharted territory. So, and we got water, because Jarl's the man, and he found water. It's awesome. Life goes on.
Interesting. So what's going on now, Joey?
Gotta go get water. And sometimes getting water isn't as simple as it sounds. Going in barefoot, probably not the best idea, but... cold right here, not even in water yet. Oh, that's not that bad. Yeah, it is. This is definitely one of those spots where like some sort of creature from the Black Lagoon just kind of jumps up out of the hole and takes me in there, and that's the last you ever see of me. So if that doesn't happen right now. Yeah, this water is almost up to my knee right now. It's bug water too, so that means it has swimmers in it. So if you're not using a filter, like I'm not using a filter, something to be aware of.
Ah, pretty soon.
water. We really don't need it at this point, but we might look for it just to see what it looks like. Slide here for sure, but we're thinking this is the vertical or the less than vertical crack. Some of veggie belay. Actually, sucks that my shoes just aren't that good. You know what? Veggie belay. Not really veggie belay, but.
How's it looking there?
It's gonna work. It's gonna go. It's a unique spot because you don't want your pack to take you down that way. It would be bad. And it's just at a weird angle, but like if you just position yourself right, you're not gonna fall.
That's pretty cool.
Southwest following a bighorn sheep trail along Coyote ledges. Do not drop to the top of the wingate, which is the slick rock. That's the wingate, that orange rock.
So Joey, any updates on the water situation?
No water. This is going to be a dry camp, but not really a big deal because we got plenty of water. Gotta say, man, this is kind of like a lifeline. I was thinking about this the other day. If this leaks or anything, I mean, my life kind of depends on it out here when you don't really have water nearby. So, kind of take it for granted, but pretty important thing. But yeah, dry camp, but we got enough to get to the river tomorrow. I think we're maybe 4 hours of walking, so that's the water update.
Good. So Joey's on a natural bridge there.
That's pretty cool.
Beautiful.
Yeah, there's definitely a way over there, but somebody walked around a bunch of deer. I wonder if they can't.
Thank you.
want some lunch now, Joey?
Lunch would be nice. What happened to lunchtime?
I guess it just passed.
We don't take breaks anymore, apparently. Jarl just wants to hike all day. Go. Go, 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 go. We gotta go. What about lunch? Hungry, man. How's it look?
Yeah. Looks like we got the crux here.
Yeah? Oh yeah, this was the part. This is the part in the picture.
Okay, should we take off packs here?
Yeah. We can.
How do we get them across?
I slide them underneath. Okay. This is basically the little crux move, or the first one we've hit. We just slid our packs underneath, but you just don't want to fall.
Oh, you want to just get me? What's that? Ugh.
So here we're gathered. Very little ledge.
Both would be bad falls. Oh my, this is awesome.
Next one.
All right, man, what do you think of this route so far?
Well, it's pretty spooky.
I'd call that some exposure.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's footprints here.
Perfect. This is, hasn't been too bad. Definitely some exposure, but it's always pretty solid footing. And I think all we need to try to do is get out to this thing, and then we're pretty set for basically having a ramp down to the river. That's
awesome.
What do you think of that, Joey?
It's awesome. That's pretty cool. It's just like he describes, pretty safe because you have this wide ledge there, but spooky at the same time because you just know, like, man, that's a straight drop. Yeah. But
how far?
Fun.
How far down do you think it was at the steepest?
Oh, doesn't matter. I might survive if I fill that one.
Yeah, this one isn't bad.
That's freaking awesome.
Yeah,
I know. Still, I mean, it's no fall zone.
Yeah, but it's all good.
Love the sound of water.
So Joey, what happened to our 5.2 climb here?
Well, the 5.2 climb is below me, and we're above it, and we didn't climb up it. So for us non-technical climbers, that's a pretty good scenario to be in, I'd say. Jarl here found another way different from Steve Allen's route. He continued on around the point on the little horse trail that Allen says not to go down, and kind of just went up the canyon, and Jarl just walked right up here and started pointing down. It's like, there's the 5.2. Actually, I don't know. Come here. Is this the 5.2? You got two options. This one looks doable. And then this one looks like the crack he's talking about, which it has some exposure. I mean, that could be done, but kind of need to be focused for that one.
Yeah. I don't know.
Another day without a lunch. Take a lunch, man?
Okay, let's do it right here. So you got your lunch there, Joey?
I do.
Happy about that?
I am. Kind of hungry. Your house letting me take a lunch break. Go, 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 go. All day again today. No break. No break. No break. You go. You go. We go up here. Oh, between the round dome and the flat dome. That makes sense. Oh, drop your pack and go hike up 100 feet to the top of that. This is awesome. So much warmer now.
There's cliff where we camped night four. Way out there. Yep.
This is like the miniature wave.
Exactly.
Called surfing out here. Controlled slide. Not even. I feel like this rock might break up. Made that look way harder than it is. I guess I wouldn't want to fall here. drop in on the other side. So we walk that spine. We're on all this kind of rock. Hey, I was just saying, hey. Hey, Tony, no brakes.
Lunch? We haven't had a break since we started, man.
Yeah.
Captain, go.
Thank you.
And then there's like a crack here. And then I think you continue that way. I think it's easier over there, Joey. There. Just go around and have a look there. I think there's steps in a crack
yeah,
here.
Okay, I see it.
I think you can get handholds on each of them, you see.
You probably can. Hold on, I'm gonna look at this more.
Okay.
Steps in here. We've ran into some other people here climbing out. Gives you some perspective. That was kind of a steep climb.
Yeah.